मने यूएसबी पिन मिली के नहीं?
हाँ मिली गई सर। चालू सर बने चालू
सो गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो दिस इज 10 डेज प्रोग्राम इजंट इट? यू आर ऑन द 9th डे। सो टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द रोल ऑफ फाजीज in combating AMR, that is antimicrobials resistance. So the history of antibiotic is very, very old one. In 1910, they used antimicrobial drugs. Effectively, in 1928, Alexander Fleming, he invented penicillin, and then that penicillin, then it was used. Conducted the clinical trials by the scientists, and then it was used widely in 1943 during World War II. And then immediately after that, it was reported that these penicillin also can be resistant by the organisms. And in the Nobel Prize speech of the Alexander Fleming, he himself told that time itself that this antibiotic can be of no use, or it can be ineffective if you grow the organisms with this antibiotic at low concentration for some time. Okay, and that way there can be the antimicrobial resistance that can be developed. Subsequent to that, the other antibiotics that were invented, and against that also immediately within no time, that is just invented in 1959, and in 1960 the resistance was reported against that. Against methicillin. And the invention of antibiotic also, you will find that it is very, very slow process and very few antibiotics as such. Very few antibiotics, that means in form of the class of antibiotics. If you see, then very few classes of antibiotics that are invented. So the last one in the 1987 that was invented, that is daptomycin. And after 30 years, there was no other antibiotic than the 2017, the new class of antibiotic that was invented. So otherwise you will find that in one class there are series of antibiotics will be there. There is erythromycin, azithromycin, like that. You'll get series of antibiotics will be there in one class. But if you want to get a new class of antibiotic, then it's a very, very rare discovery. And here you can say that it took nearly 30 years to get a new antibiotic invented. So once antibiotics were invented, then in Britain they started using these antibiotics as a growth promoters, and that was practiced, and slowly they could find that it's a reason for developing the antibiotic resistance. So they started the mass movement against the use of antibiotic in the animal feeds. So here it is depicted that the date of discovery and the resistance that was identified. Okay, here it was invented in 1928, but actually it was put to use effectively in 1940s only. Okay, so immediately when it was put to use, the resistance to antibiotic was reported. Likewise, in tetracycline, immediately after the invention, the resistance was reported. Likewise, for carbamazepine, carbapenem also, 85 it was invented, and in 93 the resistance was reported. So the very fast the organisms are developing resistance against the whatever antibiotic that you are inventing. And what are the factors they are responsible for this development of antimicrobial resistance? One is environment. So that is because of the rapid spread of the antibiotics, and particularly when it is used in the animal husbandry and agriculture, particularly practices when it is used as a growth promoter, that is the main cause of the antibiotic resistance. So when antibiotics are fed, the organisms inside the gut, they develop resistance to that one. And then in gut, it is not only the gut microbiome or the healthy microbes are there. There are pathogens also. So by gene transfer mechanism, the resistance that is there in the gut microbes, that is transferred to pathogens also. So another cause is the patient, and that is because of the poor adherence to doses, because like other medicine, say for example paracetamol or the aspirin, whenever the problem is there, disease is there, pain is there, that will be taken. When it is not there, it will not be taken. So patient, because they are not very much aware, that with the antibiotics you need to complete the one full regime, one full cycle you need to complete. They are not very much aware of that, or when we are not having any problem, we become negligent to that one. So that is the human mentality, and because of that, the medication is taken in such a way by patient, so that is responsible for the creating antimicrobial resistance. So in first attack, when they are taking one or two dose, the microbial load will come down. It is not completely vanished, but it has come down, and they stop taking antibiotics. So whatever surviving microbes are there, they are having resistance against the antibiotic, and they, because of their mechanism, and they develop the mechanism to survive against the antibiotic, and those microbes are resistance against the subsequent attack, and that time when you use the same antibiotic, it may be ineffective. So particularly may not be phenomena worldwide, but particularly in India, this is the another cause of creating the AMR, that is antimicrobial resistance, because the drug that you are taking, though it is written 250 milligram, okay, it may not be 250 milligram of antibiotic, it may be very less, okay. Actual concentration may not be sufficient, and simple reason I'll tell you, you also must be knowing that in the pharmacy, if you go, then you'll find the labels are there only for government supply. So otherwise, why there is need to write only for government supply? Because the standard of that bulk or batch of drug is such that that is a poor standard. Okay. If it is for general use, or the potency of, or the concentration of that drug is same, then whether it is government supply or general public supply, there should not be, there is no need to discriminate that or highlight that. But you will find that the qualities of medicine in government supply or otherwise of the the companies that are upstart companies and non-standard companies, they will be supplying medicine of poor quality, and because of that also you'll find that insufficient doses, and that cause the AMR. Then the physicians. So normally you'll find that any physician or the hospitals, you will find that there will be overuse of antimicrobials, and that is mainly for the reason that hospitals or the physicians, they want to make their good name. Okay, they have given medicine and you got cure. Okay, so like that impression they want to create. So instead of trying the antibiotics in sequential fashion, lower antibiotic to higher antibiotic, they start prescribing higher antibiotic and not that too, not one, two or three simultaneously, and because of that also the patients, they are developing antimicrobial resistance. And microbes themselves, because they also need to survive, they also want to survive, and whatever mechanisms you try to develop to eliminate them, they will also find the ways how to overcome that one. And because of that, to survive against the atmosphere or environment of antibiotics, they will try to get the mechanisms from the neighboring microbes, efflux pump, or the genes that are conferring resistance to that antibiotic from the neighboring microbes, and then they incorporate in their genome, and that way they become resistant to antimicrobials. So here is the chart that is given, the number of new antibiotics. Here it is not restricted to class, the total number of antibiotics that are invented. You'll find that every decade you'll find the number of antimicrobials that are that came into market, that is in 1980s it is the highest number, 42, and off late the new microbials, antimicrobials that are reduced to come in the market. So if you are not taking sufficient care, we are not getting new antibiotics, microbes are developing resistance against that, then the best thing is to manage it, or the management of the situation such that microbes are not developing resistance against the antibiotic. Otherwise a day will come that there will be infections, microbial infections, bacterial infections, and you will not be having any antibiotic left with you. So what we have to do is we need to find out mechanisms. Either you find the new antibiotics or you find the alternatives to antibiotics. What are different ways, different options that are available with us so that we can combat the infections, microbial infections. So the new strategies that can be, that is the plasmid curing, conjugation inhibitors, CRISPR-Cas technology, and then the phages. So we would like to focus today on the option that is the phages, and how phages can be employed for the combating AMR. So what is phages? It is a virus that infects a bacteria, okay, and it is most abundant organism in the biosphere. And where the phages will be? Wherever there is bacteria, there are phages, okay. So like other viruses also, these phages also cannot survive, or they cannot multiply without the host, okay. So they need host for their multiplication, and then their host is microbe. So wherever the microbes are there, you will find the phages. And that you know, they are acellular, not non-metabolic and obligate parasite. And the inventors are one British, that is Twort, Hedrick Twort. And the another one is the Felix de Herel. This is the French guy. And they coined the term, that is bacteriophage, and its meaning is bacteria eater, the one which eats the bacteria. And there are 1,000 types of phages are there, which can infect different type of bacteria or archaea. So we'll give some brief about this. All of you are knowing what these viruses are, how they are surviving in the living host. There are two ways, that is One is the light tick cycle, and name itself suggests that there will be lysis. Okay. So what does it mean? There will be host will be there, bacteria, then phage will attach to that. It will insert the nucleic material. This nucleic material will multiply, and after multiplication, it will synthesize the organelles of the phage. And once the organelles are there, nucleic acid is there, then it will be packaged, and full phage particles are formed. And once they are complete, then there will be lysis of the host cell, and the phages are released in the atmosphere or in the environment, and the cell, host cell, will die. Okay. And alternatively, there is lysogenic cycle, and in that the host cell will be there, nucleic acid will enter in that. So additionally, one more mechanism that is taking place is this nucleic acid that get inserted or incorporated into the host genome. Okay. And it becomes part of the host genome. Then it multiplies, and when it is multiplying, DNA nucleic acid is multiplied. Simultaneously, the particles of this one, whatever the organelles required for the virus, they are also synthesized. The cell also is dividing, and then it is synthesizing the virus organelles also, and new virus particles are formed, and again the lysis is also taking place. Simultaneously, whichever cells have survived, they are also dividing, multiplying along with the incorporated phage nucleic acid. So this is lysogenic cycle, in that the bacteria is also surviving. Likewise, it is also multiplying the organism, releasing the organism. So both the processes are going on simultaneously. So that's why it is called lysogenic cycle. Okay. Now, so it is very simple, isn't it? Now, the host is there and phages are there. If you have phages, instead of killing the host, that is bacteria, instead of using antibiotic, you use the phage. Phage will kill them. Okay, it's that simple. And so that way, you can consider the phage as the therapy for that one. Okay. And if you want to see actually what is or how it is happening, you can take a petri plate and you make the lawn of the microbes, and you take the specific bacteriophage and inoculate on the plate, and you will find the round transparent zones are developed. Okay. So there the phages are multiplying. Okay. And because of that, the small wells are formed. So that way, it is killing the microbes. Now, if you are considering phage as the therapy, then now there are two options. One is either you consider the phage components as the treatment, or the whole phages. So what are the merits and demerits for that one? So for phage components, that you can consider the lysine and cholines. These are the two proteins that phage is synthesizing. So you can use the lysine as such, and as the name suggests, the role of this protein is to lyse the host cell. And the cholines, the name suggests that it creates hole. Okay. So when you are considering whole phase, then one phase infect the bacterium and release the thousand of phages, and these phages in turn will infect other bacteria, and that way the cycle will go on till the last organism or the host is survived. What is the limitation with the whole phase? So it is specific phase is required for a particular bacteria, and development of resistance to phage attachment. These phages are very, very host specific. That means when you are considering a phage against the Salmonella or Salmonella typhi, not only that, in Salmonella typhi also that is strain 1657, then the you will find the phages that are very, very specific to the strain specificity. That means a phage that is killing one strain may not be in position to survive or enter or multiply in other strain or other bacteria. Forget about the species, forget about the genera. Okay, so that specificity is there. That means you should have the battery of phages against varieties of bacteria, then only you can use them as a treatment option. But when you are considering the phage component, then these proteins are not specific, isn't it? They do their job. Okay, their job is to lyse, that means they will lyse. Okay, so irrespective of bacteria or strain, there is no specificity and they will carry out the job. The problem is the requirement of this will be more, because if the infection is high, you require more amount of lysine protein, likewise for the holins. Here whole phage, they will multiply of their own and then they will complete the infection. So this is the difference between if you want to use phage components as a treatment agent or the whole phage. Now, if you see the difference between phage therapy versus antibiotic. So, first one is, this is highly specific, as I told. You require a phage that is specific for that bacteria, species or strain, whereas antibiotic, they are having the broad range. Okay, they do not recognize whether it is specific for a strain or the genus or nothing like that. The entire range of bacteria, and some antibiotics, they are not even specific. Some are specific for gram negative, gram positive, like that. Whereas some antibiotics, they are broad spectrum, act against gram positive, negative both. Only pathogen can be targeted, so that is the advantage. Okay, other than pathogen, so when you are having dysentery or diarrhea and you are taking antibiotic, so what is happening is that along with the pathogenic organism, the commensals, gut commensals, they are also killed. Whereas when you are taking the phage as a therapy, only and only the causative organisms, they are targeted and they are killed. Whereas in antibiotic, since it is broad range, you cannot control that. And even the healthy bacteria, that also will die. And because of that, you will have some other problems. Indigestion, infection, like that, problems will be there. So HAAS is bactericidal, whereas antibiotics can be of different types, whether it can be bacteriostatic also and it can be bactericidal also. Effective on both antibiotic sensitive and resistance bacteria. So, but on the contrary, here also you will find that only sensitive bacteria, the antibiotic will be working. Contrary that, HAAS are very highly specific. So that is another drawback. Here they are not selective for the sensitive or resistant, but they are specific for their strain. Okay, that way. Their number increases till the last bacteria is surviving. Okay, so with a minimal dose of HAAS, you can cure the infection. Whereas antibiotic, you need to give the amount of antibiotic and the dose, you need to repeat periodically till the infection is removed. Little intrinsic toxicities and side effects. Okay, so almost there are nil side effects, but antibiotics do have side effects. Okay, minimal symbiosis of a normal flora, whereas may disrupt normal flora. Easy administration. In past therapy, so far only topical applications are invented. The injection or other type of application and route of administrations are not recommended or not tested. Whereas the problem with the route of administration, okay, safe, better tolerant and less expensive. Whereas antibiotics, it depends. If you are taking the sulfonamides, they are cheaper one. Whereas other antibiotics, higher antibiotics, they are very, very costly. Only single or few doses are required, and dose required till the infection is recovered. No toxicity to animal, plant and the environment. This is more important, but it may be toxic, and they are imparting to AMR also. HAAS resistance is rare. This is debatable. Antibiotic resistance is common and takes few months. If you want to develop a HAAS against any specific strain, then you need some time to get that. Otherwise, for this one, development of antibiotic takes several years. So what are the limitations of HAAS therapy? The selection of appropriate HAAS, because once you are having a disease or infection, you need to identify which is the causative organism, and against that causative organism, which HAAS will be effective. So you screen your library. If you are in the lab, you are having the battery of HAAS. In that, if that HAAS is there, you take out, multiply it, and then use it. Otherwise, you need to get new HAAS for that. HAAS host range, okay. Normally, it happens that one HAAS will act on one bacteria only, okay. But one bacteria can be attacked by number of HAAS, okay. What dose or amount of HAAS should be used, that is also not standardized. Reduced activity due to immune system response. If you use this HAAS as a medicine and intravenous, or you take orally, then there are all possibilities that your body system or immune system will react to that and develop antibody against those HAAS. May trigger the immune system to overreact. There may not be enough kind of HAAS to treat all bacterial infections. So whichever are identified and they are in the repository, that R only can be used. Some HAAS may cause bacteria to become resistant. So this we'll see in subsequent slide. Shifting of phases create biosafety issues, and patenting issue discourages capitalists from investing in the first therapy. So this is the main hurdle, because phase is a living entity, and any living entity cannot be patented. So you cannot patent phase. So even if you invent phase, it has to be in public. Anybody can copy it, and anybody can multiply it and use as a drug substance in that preparation. So those companies who want to invest in the identifying new phases, so they are reluctant to do that because they cannot have the IPR in that one. Then how or what is the bottleneck in the fast therapy? So that is called CRISPR, that is clustered regulatory regularly interspersed short palindromic regions, CRISPR, and then the CRISPR associated gene, that is Cas. There are several types of Cas are there, and that provide adaptive immunity against phages. Okay, so you know that the bacteria, like eukaryotes, they are also having two type of immunity. One is innate immunity, and another is the adaptive immunity. Okay, so which one is the innate immunity in bacteria? Which is the innate immunity?
Cell membrane structures.
So bacteria, some bacteria invariably having some restriction enzymes. Okay, naturally anytime they will be having the restriction enzymes. Okay, and this restriction enzymes will chop the inserted DNA. Okay, it may be from the phages or like that. Okay, so any DNA that comes, and that DNA is having that recognition site, so it will be chopped off. Okay, all of you know that. Okay, so that is the innate immunity of the bacteria, whereas this CRISPR is the adaptive immunity. So why it is called adaptive immunity? Because when there will be a viral attack or phage attack, the phage nucleic acid will enter the bacteria. So once it is entering the bacteria, a part of viral nucleic acid that will be chopped off, and that sequence it will get inserted into its genome. That is the CRISPR site. At the CRISPR site, this part of the this viral genome that will be inserted, and then it is multiplying. Okay, so this phage will kill the organism, before that it may multiply also. But once this has inserted in that, this will go to the next generation, and that time when the phage attacks comes, this organism will use the system, CRISPR-Cas9 system. It will synthesize the guide RNA using this inserted DNA, and then it will form the CRISPR RNA. This CRISPR RNA will bind with the viral RNA with complementarity, and then it will cleave off, chop off the virus genome. So that way it will not allow the phage to multiply. Okay, so this is normally not present, but once the virus attack is there, it recognizes, it remembers it, and then in the next subsequent attack, it acts against that. Okay, so that's why it is adaptive. Like you are having a bacterial or viral infection, that time you fell ill, but you recover and you develop antibody. And during subsequent attack, viral attack, your antibody are used to neutralize that virus. So that way, this CRISPR is the adaptive immunity of the bacteria. Okay. Then what are the mechanisms you want to overcome the PAS resistance? Okay. Because PAS bacteria developing resistance against PAS also. Okay. So what you can do is you can use the PAS cocktail instead of one PAS, because as I told, PAS is specific to the strain. But for a bacteria, then there can be varieties of PASes that can attack you. So you can use the cocktail of PAS for that bacterial infection. Alternatively, you can use the PAS enzymes like the lysine and holins, the proteins that you can use. Or what can be done is the PAS and antibiotic together you can apply. Okay. So resistance will develop only if any of the organism during that time is survived. Okay. If you are effectively killing all the organisms during that event, then there is very less little chance of developing resistance against that. Okay. Or you can have the engineered phases, chimeras of that one, and then that way you can deceive the bacterial CRISPR system. Okay. Or you can modify the phases with the help of CRISPR system and then develop the new phases for the treatment. So FDA has approved the bacteriophage therapies, and but most of them you will find that they are mainly for the food and other beverages, or at the most they are for the external application like wound and other thing. Okay. But no phase so far approved for the internal issues. I'll call you in some time. Okay, no issue. Okay, but in market the PAS therapy is there, and the main companies are by the inventor. They invented the PAS and they are using as a treatment. So but these are the few references from that this material is taken. So if you have got any question, queries, that I can answer. Yes.
Sir, whatever condition it is in, whatever pathogenic condition is that, if you use the PAS, it may happen in the sudden time the mutation occur and intercalate with the host itself, not bacteria, but the organism itself. Again, who is in a pathogenic condition? It may happen that will develop the new pathogenesis in that organism?
See, I told you in the beginning, these polys are very, very specific for the host. If they are specific for a strain, Salmonella Typhi 1657, then they will not be in position to attack any other Salmonella also. Okay, so to that specificity they are made. So forget about that leaving the bacteria aside, they will attack human. No possibility.
But if the lysis occurs, the DNA is fragmented, it may be.
So understand, daily in our body, not only ourselves, the bacteria and other organisms, they are dying, their DNA is released and it is metabolized on a daily basis. Okay. It is not me. Yes.
So
it is
called that there are two types of we can use two one patch component or patch whole patch. So in the case of patch component, there are lysin and molybdenum. So is there any specificity for gram negative bacteria, like outer membrane in the gram negative bacteria, but gram positive bacteria only have cell wall on the outer?
Yeah, so there is specificity for that one, and mainly you can use for the gram negative bacteria very effectively, but for gram positive bacteria you should have the phages acting against that, and their component you can use as a component treatment.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for a wonderful explanation of our bacterial therapy. It is almost a very traditional way of treating because naturally it is present there. And then in the last slide, sir, you were explaining that it is mainly for the food preparation, beverage, and then the tropical application. So what is the limitation, why we are not going beyond that for the last 10, 12 years in some parental therapy like this?
So I told that the inventor, the Hellerin and the Ford, they have made companies and they are making the past preparation and they are selling also. Okay, other companies are also there, and for several of the external exterior application preparation are there in the market. Okay, but when you want to take it inside mainly, and particularly if you want to go for the IV route or like that, then same thing, they will be treated as the foreign protein, and against that your body will create the immune response. So that is the biggest limitation that is being faced for the bacterial first.
For this, what we clinical trial will require? What are the basic parameters for this? If you want to use this in case of humans.
Same, whatever you require for the antibiotics or other drug molecules, same type of the clinical trials you require for this one. But mostly the MNCs are not coming forward, or the pharmaceutical companies are not coming forward, because they cannot patent it. And after doing so many clinical trials and wasting spending money on that, if they cannot patent it, so there is no fun in doing that. Okay, so that's why there is limited interest in the bacteria class.
Sir, once we take a phage therapy, it will kill all the bacteria and only one dose is required, then what is the idea of doing a phage and antibiotic combination therapy?
Yeah, so if at all by chance any organism is left out, as I told that not all bacteria, they are having the CRISPR system. But for sake of understanding, you understand that you are having a phage against a bacteria that is having CRISPR system. So you are giving phage therapy. So when you are giving phage therapy, that phage will try to kill that bacteria. But surviving bacteria
will have the nucleic acid inserted in that, and then adaptive immunity is generated. So those bacteria you require to kill by different mechanism, isn't it? Otherwise, if they are surviving, the FAS will be ineffective, isn't it? So FAS and antibiotic. So whichever are escaping FAS, they will be killed by antibiotic. No more question. Okay. Thank you very much for patiently hearing.